and welcome to Tech Savvytri. This is a show where we showcase tech reviews, discuss current tech news and what to do's. I'm your host and Tech Savvytri, Samantha Fernandez. In today's episode, I'm going to review the Moto G7 Power smartphone. And we'll also talk about some ridiculously expensive tech. And from our expert at Savvytri, we'll hear about what brands can do to give their customers premium service. So, on with the show, and here we go! Motorolla has been dishing out some great products at decent prices with good specs. Overall, they seem to be doing quite well. The Moto G7 Power is another new release in their G series of handsets. And I got my delicate little fingers on this powerhouse handset. So, without further ado, here are some of the things I liked about the Moto G7 Power. First off, the handset scores well in the looks department with a rather premium-like design and finish. And although it may be a tad bit heavy, and we'll get to that why in a bit, it's quite well balanced. Sticking to the design, I'm not a fan of the rear position fingerprint scanner, but I absolutely love that they use their logo to house the sensor. And if that's a problem, just use the face unlock option. And it even supports USG OTG, so I can plug in a pen drive even if I want to. For that, it has my respect. So, when it comes to its weight, 193 grams, that pretty much comes from the whopping 5000 milliampere battery. Complete with fast charging, you'll be ready to go with just a few minutes of charging. And go on and on and on and on. Everything runs silky smooth on the Moto G7 Power. You'll see no lag while gaming or just using the device daily. The 64GB of onboard storage can be beefed up to about 512GB with a memory card. It's a single camera setup with a single 12MP primary and LED flash.
For a single camera, it does a fairly good job of capturing images with decent amount of bokeh for portraits.
And now for a few things I didn't quite like about the Moto G7 Power. The 6.2 inch display is not full HD, but has 720p resolution. Although it's going to make the battery even more impressive, I think Moto could easily have gone with a higher resolution here. The trade-off for the premium glossy plastic finish is that it can be slippery on smooth surfaces. A quick fix is to get a cool cover. Problem solved. Priced at around 14,000 rupees with the huge battery being its primary USP, Moto G7 Power has plenty of competition. But in my experience, Motorolla has always been that brand that never backs down. In a nutshell, the Moto G7 Power is a decent handset, especially for people who travel a lot and need a powerhouse device that will run easily for over 2 days. Now, let's talk about some outrageously expensive technology that you can't help but crave, even if you'd have to sell a kidney to own some. First on the list is the $1.45 million speakers. Siren by Metaxas and Sins, a Dutch company, cost much more than a luxury home here in India. These guys make ridiculously expensive speakers. The 1.7 meter tall floor standing speaker is crafted out of 7 aluminum pieces, with each starting out as a solid block. These are carefully carved using a special machine called a computer numerical control router. The whole process takes about 2 months. 1.45 million is just the starting price. Shell out an additional $15,000 and you can enjoy a smoother, high-range performance using diamond tweeters. Even if you don't survive an earthquake, at least your audio system will. Moving on to the absolutely beautiful Mercedes-Benz F015 Luxury. It's a self-driving car that has been designed to offer the ultimate futuristic luxury riding experience that you can get. Experts say it would easily cost more than $10 million. The four-seater vehicle looks and feels more like a digitally equipped luxury lounge. Lots of leg space and interiors made out of complementing organic metal and synthetic materials definitely bring out the makes of the L in luxury. Given that it's a driverless car, you won't have to worry about learning to drive. You can communicate with the car using the digital panels inside and undoubtedly a handy app to do everything else. It even has LED signal panels outside that could indicate the cars behind to stop. And the best part is the electric hybrid system that can run up to 1,100 kilometers without recharging. Wow! Of course, it's not quite ready for the roads yet and could be a few years before we see this become a reality. But just a look at this stunning vehicle is enough to make you want to rob a bank. A very large bank. Here's something we might just be able to afford. Sony's cute little robot pet, Ivo. Set at around $2,900, this robot dog is not only cute, but is almost as good as a real pup. Minus the poop and the shedding of fur. Yeah. Ivo comes with 3 years of Sony's AI cloud service, plus paw pads, toys, and a charging station. It also comes with a cloud-connected deep learning artificial intelligence engine and advanced image sensors. This robo-dog can not only learn to recognize faces, it can also learn which actions bring you joy and develop its own unique personality through everyday interactions. Ivo has the ability to move along a total of 22 axes with eye, ear, and tail movements, as well as different voice sounds and blinking. It can even play games with children and overall is pretty cool AI for a robo-dog. Well, all I can say is it's a good thing I can't afford an Ivo, because my cats would go crazy. Now time to get some tech insight from our resident Savvytri expert, Srivatsa Prabhakar, founder of Savvytri. Hi Srivatsa.
Hey Sam, good to talk to you again.
So today we wanted to pick your brain about how tech brands can provide the best value to their customers.
So in our belief, it's no more about just the devices, but also associated services and aspects such as offering genuine accessories, authorized protection plans, giving guaranteed buyback prices, offering great upgrade programs, etc., etc. For example, you just reviewed the Moto device. We actually are offering the branded authorized protection plans. So consumer has one window where he can get excellent customer experience in addition to the great product that he owns.
That's good to hear, man. Thanks, Srivatsa. Well, that's it for today, guys. Please keep watching this show so that I can make money doing more shows and maybe afford a real hot dog. This is your Tech Savvytri Sam signing off.